This video will teach you how to properly bleed your rebar cutter. If your rebar cutter is running slow, isn't moving, or doesn't have the pressure to cut normally, you may need to bleed the hydraulics. Step 1. If the piston is still moving, run the tool for 30 seconds to warm up the oil inside. If the piston is not moving, add oil before warming it up for 30 seconds. Step 2. When the oil is warm, run the piston out just before it returns and stop. Step 3. Remove the oil plug and top it off with oil. Step 4. Make a seal with your thumb or finger over the oil plug opening. Step 5. Run the tool so that it makes a complete cycle. Step 6. When the piston is completely retracted in the open position, gently roll your finger to let unwanted air escape. Step 7. Repeat steps 5 and 6 at least 3 times. Step 8. Add oil only when the piston is at least halfway out. Step 9. If more oil is required, repeat steps 5 and 6. Step 10. Replace the bolt and tighten it, and retract the piston. Before each use, be sure to warm up the tool for at least 30 seconds. Step 11. Make 3 to 4 cuts with rebar. The machine should now be working properly. Make sure that you observe exactly what point the rebar is actually breaking. Step 12. Pinch a piece of rebar, stopping just before it actually breaks. Step 13. Remove the oil plug again and top off the reservoir one last time. Step 14. Replace the bolt and tighten. The operation is now complete. One final tip. If you're not using the stopper bolt correctly, you could find that a piece of rebar is jammed in the machine at an angle. On newer machines, all you have to do is simply release the pressure valve to retract the piston. For more information, visit bnproducts.com.